Yes, this format is back, my dedicated elevator tour video format. And to begin with, I have as many as 13 elevators to show you in the campus area belonging to the University of Bonn. Let's begin by visiting the elevators on this map, and we begin at the top of the map, in the data center building. Here are a total of 4 stall traction elevators. All of them have been modernized. 3 of them, one shown in this map, are passenger elevators with folding inner doors. But I only filmed the freight elevator. It has no inner doors and a key is required to call and operate this elevator.
Es ist einfach, ja, es ist Enthusiasmus, ne? Technik und alles so weiter. Ständig schauen die Leute zum Beispiel alte Züge finden.
Okay.
Das ist inzwischen sehr populär geworden.
Ja, wow, very slow.
Ja, the last 30 centimeters.
Lovely. Now I have to go all the way up. This was original stall from 1962. It has been modernized by Schumacher. Very nice elevator. You can almost look through the hole here.
Takes forever to arrive from the lower basement up to floor 6.
I think it was floor 3, or was it?
Sorry?
We're sorry, yes. Second.
The reason for the strange color is that a former professor was partially founded by Telecom. Telecom, and this is basically their color.
All right.
That's nice.
Better than the gray color they're using on these elevators. know since when they have rebelled this already to be like this?
I don't know.
Okay.
Take the rifle off both of the lifts.
No.
I wanted to do that.
To the right of the first elevator, we come into the Institute for Applied Psychics building, and we find a classic 1953 Sizer elevator. It has received inner doors and new cab buttons, but it is otherwise original and for public use.
Very classic. Sizer.
Going down along the map and then turning to the right side, we find ourselves in the Institute of Psychics building. The first elevator we find has no inner doors, but is a public elevator with 90 degrees door arrangement. It was built in 1966 by Hafline and Windeck.
Floor E2 doesn't work, yeah. E2 down to E1. That's special.
Following further into the corridor, and we find another elevator from Hefeline and Windeck. This one is built in 1963, but has received a cab interior overhaul. Did I mention that it has a pair of folding in doors? In the far right of the map, we find a Hoopman elevator, also with folding in the doors. It was built in 1966, but has been modernized in 1996, with new controllers and fixtures. It is 2-speed traction still.
Door 2 is locked off, but someone called me there, and not anyone, but a certain one. He has gone away now. Brian's 1996 version, built 1966.
Now we go to the bottom left of the map and find ourselves in the Helmholtz Institute building. This elevator is in a restricted part of the building. It is built in 1994 by Helfelein and Windeck. Surprisingly enough, it has no inner doors whatsoever and has therefore been locked off. We are now in the public part of the building, and here we find a 1957 built Helfelein and Windeck elevator, also without inner doors and locked off from operation.
Wir kommen dann zurück gleich, ne? Mit dem Basement? Oh, warte.
Ja,
ja. Okay.
Here's the basement floor.
Yes.
Alright, we're up again. Another lap.
Pardon? Okay, 1 second, one then.
Yes.
Kennen Sie den 54er Rüben?
54er?
Regel 10?
Regel 10? Ja, den kenne ich, glaube ich. Der von Friesen, oder?
Ja.
Leaving the map, we have more elevators to go. They all are scattered around in the campus with one single building containing an elevator each. We begin with a rather large elevator built by Hammersbeck in 1961. It has folding inner doors, but despite that, it is locked off inside. Special key to operate it from inside. Next to it, we enter Steinmein Institute for Geology and Paleontology, where we find a Heflin and Windeck elevator from 1962. This one also received a cab overhaul with folding inner doors and new fixtures. Now we are entering the Institute for Photogrammetry building, where we can find a small Hammersbeck elevator from 1960. It has been slightly modernized with inner doors and new cab fixtures. Thank you. inside the Institute for Plant Disease building, there's a small passenger elevator built by Heffelein and Windeck back in 1965. It has been modernized by the same company in 1994 with new controllers. It has no inner doors and is locked off from calling. When it is not in use, it parks between floors to prevent anyone to use it without a key.
Between these floors, so no one can use it. Just let wait until this elevator want to park between the floors. Gonna take a while. This also have a simple memory. Mm. Something like that.
Nobody can remember the chords.
All inside chords can be collected. But not the outside chords, apparently.
Damn.
We are now heading to the Institute for Agricultural Technology, where we can find a huge elevator from Leonhard Peters by 1957. It has locked doors and is locked off from operating, but you might find it is left with an open door and inserted key most of the time.
That's funny.
Okay, then. Come.
dann nur mit der Schuss.
We finish off this tour by visiting the Institute of Animal Science, where we find a 1955 half-line and Windeck elevator. It has received inner doors and the shaft door has been replaced at some point in recent years.
Small. I fixed it just back here.